1 week ago today, automatic spending cuts went into effect in Washington. And the president warned that they would cause serious problems for Americans.
Gordon, the administration even cut back on tours of the White House. But conservatives and even the news media are asking if some of those budget cuts were just motivated by politics. Well, John Waukee has the story.
President Obama's political opponents and even some in the media want to know if the mandated cuts are being used to scare up public opposition to more federal belt tightening.
The White House is our house!
With the president's office announcing that it will cancel spring visitor tours of the White House, the Wall Street Journal published an editorial called Hashtag Sequester This, in which it skewers the White House strategy to, quote, punish eighth graders visiting from Illinois instead of, say, the employees of the Agriculture Department who will attend a California conference sipping exceptional local wines and sampling tasty dishes prepared by special guest chefs. Meanwhile, an ABC reporter asked Agriculture Secretary Tom Vilsack if it's time to stop doing oil portraits of former secretaries at more than $22,000 a pop.
You know, there are so many questions I'd be happy to answer about our budget. I just think that's a really small ball kind of question.
Correspondent David Curley then had his photo blown up at Costco for under $100. The questions may be taking their toll as President Obama abandoned last week's take-no-prisoners strategy against Republicans and by midweek was wining and dining lawmakers, a group of senators one night, and House Budget Chairman Paul Ryan the next day. The House's top Democrat, Nancy Pelosi, approves.
I think, as one who has been a leader in the Congress for a while, I always think it's very important to understand the motivation of members and what the possibilities are in terms of courage.
House Speaker John Boehner expressed surprise that the president changed tactics from campaign events around the country to sitting down and talking with lawmakers.
I think it's a sign, a hopeful sign. I'm hopeful that something will come out of it. But if the president continues to insist on tax hikes, I don't think we're going to get very far. If the president doesn't believe that we have a spending problem, I don't know if we're going to get too very far. But I'm optimistic.
Despite the current camaraderie, yet another extension of the debt limit lies ahead this month, leaving both sides bracing for another battle. John Waukee, CBN News.
Well, at least they're talking with one another. That's an improvement. Mm-hmm. But if they can ever get together on a deal on a budget that actually cuts spending, that'll be a true miracle. Well, the White House has another political problem on its hands. Lee Webb has that story from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Yeah, and even Democrats are talking about this one, too. Gordon, the Obama administration is postponing an award for an Egyptian women's rights activist because of anti-American and anti-Semitic comments posted on her Twitter account. Samira Ibrahim was going to be one of the 10 recipients of the International Women of Courage Award. But the Weekly Standard Online found that Ibrahim supported the attack on the U.S. consulate in Libya September 11th. She applauded a bus attack that killed five Israelis, and she attributed all crimes against society to Jews. Ibrahim denies writing those messages. She claims her Twitter account was hacked. But Illinois Democratic Senator Mark Kirk calls that claim dubious, and Ibrahim refuses to apologize for her anti-Zionist statements. Osama bin Laden's son-in-law faces a federal judge in New York on charges of conspiring to kill Americans. Government officials applaud the arrest, but some Republican lawmakers are raising questions now about the way the administration is handling this high-profile prisoner. Charlene Israel has that story.
The arrest of Suleiman Abu Ghaith is a major victory for the U.S. Osama bin Laden's son-in-law and the former spokesperson for al-Qaeda, he's considered a key target. But a group of Republican lawmakers aren't celebrating just yet. They call the New York City trial by a federal judge bad precedent.
We're now setting a new precedent that will come back to bite us. You're putting people like this into federal court, giving them the same constitutional rights as an American citizen.
Graham, along with Senator Kelly Ayotte, say Abu Ghaith should be interrogated and face a military tribunal at Guantanamo Bay. They accused the Obama administration of going around Congress and sneaking the terror suspect into New York City. Abu Ghaith was captured in Turkey and transferred to Jordan, where the U.S. took custody of him last week. According to U.S. officials, the CIA has been tracking him for years as he moved from Afghanistan to Iran and then to Turkey.
This is a man who was in the inner circle of bin Laden's al-Qaeda operations, and now we have him alive. And he's talking.
U.S. officials say Abu Ghaith has already revealed key intelligence about the current status, personnel, and finances of al-Qaeda. In a statement, U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder said, quote, "This arrest sends an unmistakable message. There is no corner of the world where you can escape from justice because we will do everything in our power to hold you accountable to the fullest extent of the law." Prosecutors say that during his time as al-Qaeda spokesman, Abu Ghaith applauded the attacks of 9/11 and warned there would be more. Officials say more recently, he was part of an al-Qaeda senior management council. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Former President Bill Clinton says the U.S. Supreme Court should overturn the Defense of Marriage Act. Clinton signed that law in 1996 when he was president. It says that marriage is between one man and one woman. That means a state where gay marriage is illegal does not have to recognize gay marriage from another state. But it also means gay married couples don't receive federal benefits. But Clinton now believes the law discriminates against same-sex couples, and he calls it unconstitutional. Pro-choice activists will challenge a new law in Arkansas that limits abortions. The law bans abortions after 12 weeks of pregnancy if an ultrasound shows that the unborn baby has a heartbeat. The activists say the new law violates Roe v. Wade, the Supreme Court decision that legalized abortion nationwide. Arkansas legislators, though, who voted for the law, expected a legal challenge. France will start pulling its troops out of the African nation of Mali next month. They have been fighting, of course, in Islamic militants there. But that Islamic threat remains very real, and Operation Blessing is there to feed and assist those caught up in this conflict. Gary Lane has more from Bamako, Mali.
CBN News joined Operation Blessing in the capital city of Bamako as it fed a group of refugees. Most fled the Islamist takeover of the northern city of Gao. While they found temporary housing, they still depend on the generosity of others to help feed their children. Ali Matu Diara was pregnant when her family made the 600-mile journey from Gao to Bamako. Her baby was born with an abdominal hernia. Tiny Abdu Malik underwent surgery, but his condition has not improved. Operation Blessing asked this doctor to examine little Abdu. He says the first surgery wasn't done well. This baby has an infection, and his intestine could come out again. Abdu's mom is now awaiting results from an ultrasound test, paid for by Operation Blessing. He may need another surgery. She told us, "I am grateful to God and you for the high quality of beans and rice that you've provided. Also for your concern for my baby."
Not only are refugees and victims of the war being fed and cared for, but CBN is doing what it can to help change the lives of young women.
19-year-old Fatima will soon graduate from the sewing school. She attends classes here because she wants a better future. She hopes to start her own sewing shop. And she wants to be a blessing to others. CBN helped Pastor Yurino Chori begin the sewing school in 2004. 14 young women started classes back then. Today, more than 120 students are enrolled here. They attend classes for 3 years. Pastor Chori says without job skills, many of these young women would turn to prostitution to support their families. Divorced women also receive training here.
When a woman is divorced with 3, 4, 5 children, and she can't earn her own life, that's misery.
Some of these students are non-Christians. Chori often reads Bible verses to the women and teaches them about Christianity.
We have received some who have become Christians, and they follow the Lord. They want to go to church.
So in a time of war, CBN is helping Malians meet some of their immediate needs, receive job training for the long term, and spiritual truth for eternity. Gary Lane, CBN News, Bamako, Mali.
Real picture of the gospel, isn't it, Gordon, to see God taking what was once broken and putting it back together again?
That's right. And if you want to help out with Operation Blessing, we invite you to do so. All you have to do is call us, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, "I want to give to Operation Blessing Disaster Relief." And whether those disasters are here in the United States or around the world, and whether it's from natural disasters or the disaster of war, We want to be there and we want to help people. So if you want to do that, you can give to Operation Blessing, Disaster Relief Fund. The address is on the screen, CBN Center, Virginia Beach, Virginia, 23463. Or you can just call us and say, I want to designate my gift to Operation Blessing Disaster Relief.
Students at a Massachusetts charter school will perform a biblical play of Genesis with gay characters. It is a 1998 comedy called The Most Fabulous Story Ever Told. Many say it's offensive to Christians. Some describe it as blasphemous and hateful. In a letter to parents, though, administrators at the Pioneer Valley Performing Arts School said the play is consistent with the school's philosophy and appropriate for a high school audience. But they admit receiving email petitions and phone calls protesting the play. 20 student volunteers from the Atlanta-based Master's Commission joined CBN's Operation Blessing for a major outreach in California. They spent a week providing food to hurting families and the homeless. The students also help with community children's programs and other events designed to bless people in need. Teams worked with five Operation Blessing partner groups and served more than 1,000 families in a week. You can find out more about Operation Blessing by going to its website at ob.org.